Good evening. Welcome to St. Andrew. We are happy you have joined us as we celebrate the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. I am Shirley Gofrank. The lectors for this Mass are Tom Ench and Cindy Potwardowski. Our music will be led by Stefan Paul. Our cantor is Mark Tisdale. Serving the Mass are Charlotte Grems and Elena Zayuna. The presider for this liturgy is Father Joe, assisted by Deacon Mark. To minimize distractions during the Mass, we ask you to silence all cell phones and personal devices. Now please stand and greet one another.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we celebrate this Mass and open our hearts to the Lord and all the graces he offers, we also want to make room by removing sin and woundedness, and also ask the Lord to help us to receive. So let's call to mind our sins, seeking the Lord's mercy and his love.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have brought us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give us yourself to heal us and strengthen us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and all. Bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, peace to people of goodwill, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in a cloud and spoke to Moses, taking some of the spirit that was on Moses. The Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders, and as the Spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but they'd been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent, and yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp, Joshua, the son of Nun, who from his youth had been on Moses' side, said, Moses, my Lord, stop them. But Moses answered him, are you jealous for my sake? Would that all of the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. Though your servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them, yet who can detect failings? Cleanse me from my unknown faults. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. From wanton sin especially, refrain your servant. Let it not rule over me. Then shall I be blameless and innocent of serious sin. The precepts of the Lord. Give joy to the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away, your clothes have become moth-eaten, your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned, you have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, John said to Jesus,
Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us. Jesus replied, Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with 2 feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with 2 eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where the worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, I turned on my microphone now. It comes from chapter 9 in Mark's Gospel. And chapter 9 begins with the transfiguration of Jesus on the mountain. And this is important because since this gospel is about sin and the consequences of sin, that lover of humankind would at least tell us what we could do to avoid it. And so in this gospel, he does tell us what we can do to avoid it. So I go back to the transfiguration that began in chapter 9 because it does have a bearing on what we've just heard from this gospel. In the transfiguration of Jesus, only three of his disciples were present. It was Peter, James, and John who were allowed to witness the transfiguration. So John has kind of a sense that he's maybe specially chosen, part of the inner circle. And it was not only that experience that impacted John, who was in the opening verses of this gospel, which is kind of rare in Mark's gospel that he would open with John, but John and Peter and James were also present at the transformation of the daughter of the synagogue official when she had died and Jesus raised her back to life. And so it was Peter, James, and John only who witnessed that. So it gives us I don't know if we're sure about the inner disposition of John. We can't really tell that. But in this opening verse, we get a glimpse of it. When he says, there was someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he's not one of us. He's not an insider. And so John is coming at this from his own perception of his own formation thus far in his journey with Jesus. So he has this perception that there's an outsider and an insider. And so rightly so, he says, they're not of our number. So let's prevent him from doing this. But he's also doing the work of Christ. So why prevent him from doing the work of Christ? So Jesus admonishes John, and he does it in this way. Whoever is not against you is for you. That's an indication to me that the divine providence is so awesomely open to everyone. Not only the insider, but the perceived outsider. I use the word perceived outsider because that's what can get us in trouble. Our own inner life really impacts the way our outer life works. If we have a good inner disposition, hopefully, it'll reflect in the way we treat others. So Jesus goes even further when not only does he say, whoever is not against us is with us, he also says, if someone gave you a cup of water, which is a real meager offering of kindness, they would not lose their reward. That's a lesson also. Some small act of kindness will not go unnoticed by Christ. As little as it may be, it will not go unnoticed. So again, he's giving us a way of avoiding falling into sin. And he uses hand, foot, eye. These are the things that get us into action. And these are the things that could cause us to sin. And what will influence us? It's our own inner experience that will influence our outer actions. Christ is the author of love. No mistaking that. And he loves us completely and deeply more than we can even love ourselves. That's how much he loves us. He loves us so much that he even gave up his own life for each of us. So love is the absolute impediment that keeps us focused on going forward. The lack of love is an impediment. So love within us helps us to dispense love for others. You've heard me preach about love before. Well, there was a time in prayer, quiet prayer, that the Lord Jesus actually introduced me to God. That experience of God was so encompassing of love. It was complete love that if I was in the Lord's presence for more than an instant, I would cease to exist. That was the experience of God's love. The flip side of that is that I exist because God loves me. We exist because God loves us. And so in this gospel, the Lord is absolutely showing us how our inner conviction can impact the way we behave in the world. And he's also telling us what to do. Do something, some small act of kindness to someone else. There's always an opportunity for us to do a small act of kindness. Each and every day of our lives, we have an opportunity to do a small act of kindness. Sometimes it's just listening. I was assigned to do some work at Denby High School in Detroit. Now, being from Brooklyn, Denby High School didn't scare me at all. So I'm driving to Denby, and I stop at a traffic signal, and a fellow comes up to the car with a tin box, and he's begging. So I reach in the visor. I always have a couple of dollars in the visor to give a beggar. Well, I reached in the visor, and there was no money in there. So I reached in my pocket, and I pulled out a $5 bill, and I wrestled with whether or not to give up the $5 bill. I was kind of stingy, but I did. I gave the $5 bill to the beggar, who put it in the tin box. I didn't know it, but he couldn't speak. He was probably deaf also. So all he could do was look at me. And in that exchange of eyeball to eyeball, there was an act of kindness. There was Christ. You never know when Christ is going to come your way and ask you to do some little act of kindness. This is what this gospel is about. Yes, it's about sin. It's also about how to avoid it. The Lord God would not leave us orphans. He would certainly impart on us the way to avoid Gehenna. It's not for us. It never will be for us. He has taken away the sin of the world, your sin and my sin. He only asks us to listen to his word and to do a small act of kindness. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, with great confidence now that our Father's love for us excels all that we need, let us place our prayers and our petitions before him.
For the church, that we may be receptive to the gift of the Spirit and be transformed by the Spirit's work in us, so that God's mercy, compassion, and presence may be manifest. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the world, may the Spirit grant them the means to work towards the alleviation of poverty, hunger, and homelessness from the earth. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all priests, especially Father Brian and Father Joe, on this Priest Appreciation Weekend, that they will be blessed abundantly as they continue their selfless service to the Lord and his holy people. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Rochester area Catholic family of parishes, that we may each use our unique gifts and opportunities to share God's love through words, deeds of healing, and offers of hospitality. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, especially Father Leon Olzamowski, that they will be treated with love and dignity by their caregivers and enjoy the healing of our loving God. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Father Leon Olzamowski, that they will be treated, for our beloved dead, especially Father Robert Schaefer, Deacon Edward Swartz, and Mary Ann Lutz, may they find peace in the welcoming embrace of the Father in the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intercessions placed in our prayer basket, and for Jean McCauley, Jerry Rosinski, and Martin Siegel, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God the Father, hear our prayer. Hear us, God the Son. Holy Spirit, hear our prayer. Mercy on your people, Lord.
Share on our hope and despair. pain is pain for you. In your joy is my joy too. All I brought together. Greatest gift of all. If you love, then you will know the Lord. We are many parts. We are all one body. And the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one. Despair on the cross that we bear.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you've made and forever praise you in your mighty works. Through Christ our Lord, and so with the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna. In the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Andrew, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Alan our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant them peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you, buddy.
Thanks, pal.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace. Grant us peace. Grant us, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
After your own heart. driven by rivers of pride. You are my rescue, maker and keeper of my life. Show me your endless measure of grace. Use me in spite that you know I am. Just as a deer runs to water, so does my soul to you, Father. Just as a deer runs to water, so does my soul to you, Father.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Join the Rochester area family of parishes for a wine and cheese event Thursday, October 3rd, 7 p.m. at St. Mary of the Hills. Do you guys know what the most famous cheeses of the world are? The cheeses of Nazareth. Oh my gosh. It's just stinky. That's just stinky. First Friday Adoration is this Friday, October 3rd, following morning mass until 3 p.m. in the chapel.
Care and Share will be collecting items for Crossroads Care Center next weekend. Items that are needed are listed in the bulletin, and donations can be left at any of the entrances of the church. Our pet blessing is Sunday, October 6th at 2 p.m. at the Bell Tower. Join us for the Mass of Anointing also on October 12th at 10 a.m. And St. Andrew's Clothing Drive is Saturday, October 12th as well, from 9 to 2 at the Activity Building parking lot. So you can get your anointing, and you can bring clothes for the poor. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord Jesus by our lives. Thanks be to God.
Send down the fire of your justice. Send down the rains of your love. Come send down the Spirit. Breathe life in your people, and we shall be peace. Just the song of your love. Give us hearts that sing. Give us deeds that ring. Make us ring with the song of your love. Send down the fire of your justice. Send down the rains of your love. Come send down the Spirit. Bring life. Send down the rains of your love. Come send down the Spirit. Breathe life in your people, and we shall be people of God. Call us to learn of your mercy. Teach us the way of your peace. Give us hearts that feel. Give us hands that heal. Make us walk in the way of your peace. Send down the fire of your justice. Send down the rains of your love. Come send down the Spirit. Breathe life in your people, and we shall be people of God. We shall be people.
Oh, you're welcome. My pleasure. Oh, thank you.